if you're black, can become a pest of this nation. Of course, the reality on the ground is completely different. I might add that you can say the exact same when it comes to women's rights and to feminism. Makes no difference if you're probably opposed to oppression, in my opinion, that you have some level of representations at the highest levels of the system. Hillary Clinton might become the president of the United States, but we all know that how that would advance women's rights. You get the point. So we need to bring at this point another, of course, famous figure, and who met Muhammad Ali on several occasions, which is Malcolm X. And Malcolm X, of course, says, amongst a whole number of other things, that really it's impossible, if you really get down to it, it's impossible to be both an anti-racist and a capitalist. And what he's saying is that given the system is intertwined inextricably with oppression, given the system that relies on the accumulation of profit and therefore the division of workers, given those things, you can't actually be in favour of both capitalism and of racial equality. And that, I think, sets people apart when it comes to the movement that we are seeing today. And here I'll end. In 1996, Muhammad Ali actually lit the Olympic cauldron in the Summer Olympic Games in Atlanta. And you go back to what happened to him after he's given this sort of national adulation for winning the Olympic medal, but then put in jail. And it seems, in my view, to reflect a sense of hope. Because I think that's what we do have to end this talk on. Because while we see all of the terrible things that we see today, the division, the racism, the war, the economic inequality, the poverty, all of these things, Muhammad Ali represents something which I think never disappears throughout all of those trials. And that is, in essence, his determination against the odds, his willingness to put himself into positions of pain often, his willingness to make sacrifices, but also his determination that all along the way, no one's going to be better than him. Not in the boxing ring, and not intellectually. Not versus William Buckley or anyone else. And it's that sense of determination that I think gives us hope and gives us reason to celebrate his life.
Thank you very much.